Hey, this is Presh Talwalkar. A single alien lands on Earth. Every day after that, each alien on Earth undergoes a transformation, which could be any of the four equally likely events. The alien could die. The alien could do nothing. The alien could replicate itself, which means there are two aliens in total. Or the alien could replicate itself two times, which means there are three aliens total. What is the probability the alien race eventually dies out and goes extinct? This question is sometimes asked as an interview question for technical jobs. Can you figure it out? Give this problem a try, and when you're ready, keep watching the video for the solution. Let's write P for the probability that an alien and all of its descendants die out. The probability that one alien and all of its descendants die out is P. The next day, there are four equally likely events. There is a 25% chance that this alien could die out. This means there's a conditional probability of one that this alien and all of its descendants die out. There's another contingency where the alien does nothing. Now the situation is exactly the same. This means the probability is still P that this alien and all of its descendants will die out. There's also a 25% chance the alien will replicate itself so that there are two aliens. Now each of these aliens will have a probability P that this alien and all of its descendants will die out. Each of these lines of aliens will be independent from each other. The probability that both of them die and all of their descendants die out will be the product P times P equals P squared. In the final 25% case, the alien replicates itself two times. Each of these aliens has a probability P of dying out and having all of their descendants die out. Each of these branches is independent from each other. The probability that all three die out will be equal to P times P times P, which is P cubed. If the probability is to exist, it must satisfy the following equation. The probability of an alien and all of its descendants dying out has to be equal to 0.25 times the quantity 1 plus P plus P squared plus P cubed. In the theory of statistical branching processes, the probability of extinction is equal to the smallest positive root of this equation. This is equal to the square root of 2 minus 1, which is approximately 41.4%, and that's the answer. Now, to be comprehensive, we should consider the other solutions to this equation. One solution is negative, and that can be disregarded because a probability cannot be negative. But the other solution is equal to 1. This would mean there's a probability of 1 that it's surely going to happen that the aliens would go extinct. How do we know that this is not the solution and that the correct solution is 41.4%? To figure that out, we have to dig deeper into the details and consider the discrete version of the problem. Let's write P sub k for the probability of an alien and all of its descendants dying out in k days. Let's consider the probability that an alien dies out in k plus 1 days. There are four things that can happen the next day. There's a 25% chance the alien dies out, in which case the conditional probability of dying out in k plus 1 days is equal to 1. There's a 25% chance the alien does nothing. Now, one day has already passed. So in order for this alien and all of its descendants to die out in k plus 1 days, the next day, this alien and all of its descendants would have to die out in k days. It would have to be one day less. The conditional probability here is P sub k. In the 25% chance the alien replicates itself, so there are two aliens, each of these aliens and all of their descendants would have to die out in k days. This is a conditional probability of p sub k squared. In the final case, the alien replicates itself two times, and each of these aliens and have a p sub k chance that that alien and all of its descendants would die out in k days. The probability of all of them dying out would be the product, which is p sub k cubed. Now, one thing to notice here is that the expected number of aliens the next day is equal to 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3, all divided by 4. This is equal to 1.5, which is greater than 1. That means the alien is more than replicating itself on average. So we can expect that there's a chance the aliens would survive. The probability of extinction should not be equal to 1. It should be less than 1. So how do we know this is true? We have this recursive equation for the probability the alien dies out in k plus 1 days in terms of the probability that it would die out in k days. We're going to show that this probability is always less than or equal to the square root of 2 minus 1. Now, what's the probability an alien would die out in exactly 1 day? Well, that's only the 25% chance that it simply dies out in the following day. This is our base case. Now, we assume this is true for all values less than or equal, less than p sub k plus 1. So we have this recurrence relation, and we can now apply the induction hypothesis on all the terms p sub k. So we'll substitute in square root of 2 minus 1 for those terms, and this all simplifies to be square root of 2 minus 1. So we have an increasing sequence of p sub k, because the probability keeps increasing as we expand the number of days. This is an increasing sequence, and we know it's bounded by square root of 2 minus 1. So in fact, this sequence will converge to the value of square root of 2 minus 1. And that in fact is the correct answer to this problem. Did you figure it out? Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. I make videos on math and game theory. You can catch me on my blog, Mind Your Decisions, which you can follow on Facebook, Google Plus, and Patreon. You can catch me on social media at Presh Talwalkar. And if you like this video, please check out my books. There are links in the video description.